Welcome to the Cruise Biology. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about the packaging of DNA helix. So the first of all, we have to know about the DNA that is present inside the nucleus. So the DNA that is present inside the nucleus of an organism. So if we calculate the size of DNA, that is more as compared to the size of nucleus. The mammalian DNA, in the mammalian DNA, the size of the DNA of diploid cell is approximately around the 2.2 meter. And the size of nucleus, that is the less as compared to the DNA. So that is the size of nucleus is about the 10 raised to minus 6 meter. So the DNA is need to be packed inside the nucleus. So it has to be packed to compensate the size of nucleus. So it has to be packed. You can calculate the size of DNA based on the number of base pair. Number of base pair multiplied by the space between them. Space between two base pair. So if we calculate in the mammalian cell, the number of base pair, that is the 6.6 into 10 raised to 9 base pair, and the space, that is 0.34 into 10 raised to minus 9 meter per base pair. So if we calculate, the size will be 2.2 meter, and the size of nucleus will be, the size of nucleus, that is the 10 raised to 6 meter. So now what happens if we know the number of length of the total DNA? So you can also calculate the number of base pair. Suppose in the E. coli bacteria, the length of the DNA, that is 1.36 mm. So you can calculate the number of base pair, that is present in the total length of DNA. So the space that you know, and the number of base pair you have to find, and the size you know about, the what is the size. So you can calculate the base pair. Now we are going to focus in the organization of the DNA, how it will be the packed inside the nucleus. So here, that is the DNA. So DNA is wrapped around the protein that is called histone protein. Now in the prokaryotic organism such as E. coli, they do not have the defined nucleus. The DNA is not scattered throughout the cell. So DNA, that is the negatively charged, it will be held with the proteins. So the DNA will be held with the protein in the prokaryotic cell. So the protein has the positively charged and the DNA has the negatively charged. So that is the it can held with some proteins. So this region is called as a nucleoid in the prokaryotic cell. Now you can see that in the eukaryotes, the organization is much more complex than the prokaryotic cell. So it requires the set of the positively charged, that is the basic proteins, that is called the histone proteins. So in the eukaryotic organisms, the DNA is held with this histone protein. This protein is made up of the amino acid. This amino acid that contains the basic charge based on their side chain. So that is the basic in nature. These histone proteins are rich in lysine and arginine. This nature of this amino acid is basic. So the histone proteins are basic in nature and positively charged. So it can bind with the DNA, it can wrap around it. You can see in this figure. Here that is the DNA, that is 2.2 meter in length. And it is wrapped around the histone protein. Right. There are the different type of histone proteins. So histone proteins is made up of the two types. That is the core histone and the linker histone. You can see that there is the four types of core histone. That is the four types: H2A, H2B, H3 and 4. This core histone makes the octamer of histone protein. Each of these core histone that contains the two subunits, that is the two H2A, 2H2B, H3 and H4. So the four type of histone make the octamer. This is, that is, you can see in this figure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This octamer and the DNA that is wrapped around this histone protein. So the DNA that is the wrapped around the histone protein. You can see here. And another histone that is called linker histone. It links the two histone like this way. It links the two histone. Right? It links the histone. So that is called linker histone. H1 histone, that is known as the linker histone. If we calculate the size, that is the histone octamer, so that the total will be 147 base pair of DNA that is wrapped around the histone protein. So that is the structure of histone protein. Now these histone proteins are wrapped around the nucleus and it condensed, it is more condensed in the chromatin fibers. So the condensation of these chromatin fibers into the chromosome that takes place as the metaphase of the cell cycle. During the cell cycle and the cell division, that is the metaphase, that is the during the metaphase, one of the phase of the cell division, this condensation is takes place from the chromatin to chromosome. You can see here the DNA, it is wrapped around this histone protein. These histone proteins, it forms the chromatin like structure, that is the 30 nanometer chromatin like fiber like structure that forms the 30 nanometer in size. Now these domains that is condensed and it forms the chromosome. So this condensation takes place as the metaphase of the cell division. Now in the eukaryotic cell, the condensation requires the also non-histone chromosomal proteins. It requires the non-histone chromosomal NHC, non-histone chromosomal proteins. That is called NHC proteins. Now this structure, that is DNA and the protein, that is called nucleosome. That is called nucleosome. So the DNA and this protein is acts like a thread like structure. So that is called a nucleosome. And it contains the repeating unit and that is forms the chromatin. Right. Now in the structure of the chromatin, it is seen as like the beads on string structure, like this way. It forms like a beads on string structure. It forms like the beads on string structure. It is wrapped around this histone proteins. Here is the histones, and it forms the like beads on string like structures. So that is the structure of DNA and histone proteins. Now if we talk about the structure of chromatin, in the structure of the chromatin, inside the nucleus there is some region of chromatin that is loosely packed, that is called euchromatin. You can see here, that is the loosely packed and the light stains. This stains, that is called light stains, that is called euchromatin part. This euchromatin part is transcriptionally active in nature, and that is the loosely packed, and it contains the light stains. This stain, that is called the euchromatin. And the another region in the nucleus, that is called heterochromatin. This heterochromatin region, that is the densely packed and the dark stain, that is transcriptionally inactive in nature and densely packed. So that is called the heterochromatin. These two part makes the this region of the nucleus. That is the first one, that is the heterochromatin and euchromatin. You can see in this figure, that is the euchromatin that contains the light stains, and the dark stain, that is the this region, that is the heterochromatin. So that is the nucleus structure. It is inside the, there is the nucleoid and the nucleus structure. So that is the nucleolus, right? And here is the nucleus, that is the nucleus. So that is all about the packaging of DNA with the protein inside the nucleus. So that is about the packaging of DNA. I hope this video is helpful to you guys. If you like my videos, then you can click the like button, subscribe my YouTube channel, and click on the bell icon for notification. I hope this is helpful to you guys. Thanks.